stiff's Joe H. Callahan. You're gonna pay me last month's rent, deadbeat, if you value your life.
Rent rooms to guys without jobs, and this is what you get, boys. Donuts. Give them to your mom.
Hey, Uncle Joe, we were down at the rag yard. Help cut up them. Put a cork in it, will
you? That's
enough. When are you two guys gonna learn to get along, huh? Three rules to a happy life. Number one, pay the bank. Number two, pay the bank.
What's number three?
Marry money. Now go on, get out of here.
Thanks, Uncle Joe.
You're welcome. Hey, watch for the cars! Whoa!
Mom, guess what? We got donuts. Uncle Joe's coming over for supper. Can I have one? I'm starving.
No.
Spoil your supper and keep your voice down.
Sorry, Mrs. Webster.
Oh, raised four of my own.
Okay, that'll be $2.50, please.
I can give you 50 cents now, and $2 in a couple of weeks, maybe. Mr. Webster's been under the weather since he lost his job. Our place is as hot as Hades.
There you go. You wish Mr. Webster well. I hope he's on the mend soon. Take that from Mrs. Webster. Fat, hold the door for your brother.
Bless you, Jack. We always pay our bills.
Jack Bailey.
Oh, for Pete's sakes, it's 90 degrees out there. The old fellow's out of work. What are you going to do? Say sorry? We can't sell you a lousy fan?
We got 24 customers who can't settle their accounts. Sooner or later, they all go on relief.
Like a hobo? Dad, we saw a hobo get beat up down at the train yard. You should have seen it.
He's exaggerating.
No, I'm not. You almost got killed, Hub.
Did I not warn you boys? I've told you again and again to stay away from the train yards.
You have got the nerve of a canal horse! Get the heck out of here!
Oh, now hold on, Mrs. Bailey! Oh, hold, you just...
Get out of here!
Haven't you got any common sense enough to stall yours?
Taking what's mine, Bailey. Now you call out your wife, or I'll call in the police.
Hey. Come on over here. You mustn't get yourself all worked up. There's no point. There's just no point at all. Sit down.
I got nothing. I got nothing to feed my family.
It'll be all right. It'll all work out. It will all work out. Not upset the kids.
Go see what's left. I'm gonna be all right.
Here we are, folks. Good old New Bedford. There's the office, boys.
Gee, it's kind of small. What's there to do here?
Plenty if you got some get up and go. In case your father didn't tell you, your grandfather was a pretty big person hereabouts. He founded this place when he struck silver 40 years ago.
I never knew that. How come you never told me that, Dad?
Because Bob's in charge of boasting in our family.
Now, that's uncalled for, Jack. I'm proud of what our dad accomplished. Well, what do you know? Grandma Bailey's. Home sweet home, sweet home, sweet home. Come on, everybody. Oh, that truck's for you, Jacko. Borrowed it from the shop. I know she looks like a bit of an old clunker, but she's got a few good miles left on her.
Hello, sweetheart.
Daddy!
Will you say hello to your Uncle Jack and Aunt Honey?
No.
I bet you don't even recognize your little cousins. Up here, he's almost ready to start shaving.
Jack and Honey, if you had a sight for sore eyes.
What is that awful smell?
Well, I'm afraid that the boys had a little in the...
Not in our new car. Bob, I warned you to take the truck.
Jack?
Grace!
Look at you! God, it's good to see you. Grace, where's Mother?
She's inside. She's probably waiting to make her grand entrance. I'm awfully glad you're here. And the boys, oh my God, how you've grown!
Say hello to your Aunt Grace.
Hi. Well, come on inside. Mother's got dinner on the table. You're right on time. Bob, she'll be pleased about that. Come on, boys, come say hello to your grandmother.
I hope you had a pleasant drive.
You look wonderful.
I can't say the same for you.
I'm just tired.
I'm sure you haven't been eating properly.
Hello, Mrs. Bailey.
Honey, here you are with your entire brood. This must be Violet. She doesn't look like our side at all. These are the young men.
Hub, Fat, say hello.
Jack, those are not Christian names. You know I don't approve of nicknames for children.
I don't see why, Mother Bailey. I've been called Toppy since I was a baby.
Hardly something to crow about. How are you, Hubert?
Fine, ma'am.
Henry. I've been known to bite on occasion, but not usually in the first 5 minutes.
Hello.
Did somebody have an accident along the way?
They upchucked in our new car, Grandmother.
Jack, there's some old shirts in the bottom drawer in your bedroom. I trust you haven't forgotten where that is. Clean up the children and don't keep us waiting. Dinner's getting ice cold.
We weren't really planning on staying for dinner. I thought we'd push right on to the lake.
Jack, you're staying. Don't just stand there. Clean up the children.
Grandfather gave Bob and I this canoe. I couldn't have been much older than you.
We would fish in that lake for hours and hours and hours.
Can we go fishing right now, Dad?
That is a brilliant idea. You know, I'll tell your mom that we're going to catch dinner for tomorrow, okay?
Okay.
Boy, I sure can understand now why I can't stay in Grandma Bear.
Now, look here, Fat. I didn't start out not liking her. She pushed me into it.
But just remember, she did give us this place. So she can't be all that bad.
Help! Hornets! Oh, my God! Oh, look after the baby!
Can't see him. It's your grandmother's wishes. Dad.
Mother and I have given this every consideration. And no matter how you slice it.
Well, you needn't concern yourselves about it. I don't want anything from either of you.
Yes, well, out of a sense of family duty, for the time being, the children can stay here in New Bedford where they will have a stable home.
Thank you very much, but I would never leave my family, not under any circumstances.
I will not allow you to take the children away with you, and that is fine.
Thank you, Mrs. Bailey, but we are going to be just fine.
If you were ever going to get back on your feet and provide a decent home for these children, You'd best put your pride in your pocket and take some honest advice. Leave them with those who have the means to care for them.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Bailey, but my children's welfare is my business.
I will not stand by and watch you wreck my grandchildren's lives.
Come on, Joe, let's go.
You listen to me, young lady. The boys are staying here with me. The baby is going to Matilda and Cousin Hughes.
Honey, think. This is for the best.
Oh, I can't get out of here. Joe, come on.
Stay where you are, Mr. Callahan. You'll never be able to hold down a job and look after the children.
You're crazy. You lay a finger on my children, and I'll get a lawyer.
Oh, you wouldn't want to go through such an experience. With no job and no money, you'd be declared an unfit mother. Any judge would send those children back to me so fast your head would spin.
Lawyers cost a bundle. Let's just settle this quietly. We'll get you a job. Maybe we can get the kids back in a couple of weeks.
No, no!
Now, nobody here is trying to hurt you or the children. Matilda is a fine, loving woman. They don't have their own children. She will look after that child as if it was her own.
I'm doing you a favor. You may not see that now, but you will one day. And you'll thank me.
Honey, it is only for a while. You are going to get back on your feet, and things will get better. Come on now, let's go tell the kids. Please.
Get your hands off me!
Look, this isn't going to do any good.
You are not going to do this to me. I'm coming back for my kids. I know exactly what you're doing. Just because you failed with Jack doesn't mean you're going to get a chance with my boys.
You killed my son as surely as you trapped him into marrying you.
Boys. I want you to listen to me. Grandma Bailey and me, we had a talk, okay? And I have to go away. I don't know for how long. I have to go back to Northbridge to get a job so that I can afford to look after us.
You're leaving us?
Grandma Bailey offered to take good care of you, just until I can get things straightened out. I hate you! Don't! Please, don't! Poor boys. You couldn't have done worse if you tried.
You stay out of this, Grace.